We'll inform you about the latest progressions and plans around the beehive in Arnhem. So I would like to give Jos a hand. So Jos Weijers.
Good morning, at least that's what it feels like. Yeah, sure. It's good morning, Carter. And good morning, Internet. I slept well, which is quite new, because there is a project that's keeping me up for quite an extent of time at the moment. It's called the Beehive 4.2. Because we have a problem, people of the world. Wrong, that one, yeah. Because we have hacker camps like this, and hacker congresses, and there's a whole lot of letter jumbo, what the heck, hacking hack large, still can't remember what OHM was all about, SHA, CCC, camps. A couple of days a year where you go out and you exchange ideas with like-minded people like this, and awesome stuff spawns out of that. Ideas, solutions, companies, whatever. I think the hacker community is the way to save the world at the moment. And we do this every now and then, but we do that, 2 days here, then we wait 2 or 3 years and we go to a different continent, do the same. If you don't want to travel the whole globe continuously, then you maybe do this, about a week, a year, something like that. That's 2% efficiency. We can do better than that, come on. We should be able to do better than that, because we're hackers. We make solutions, and that's the idea. So that's, and you might say, there are solutions for that. You can go to a hackerspace, which is basically a offline hacker congress thingy-ish. Except, most people, in most hackerspaces, you can't really spend the night. So the late night boozing will be less. And a lot of times, the best ideas happen over a drink or at a bonfire or something like that. So I do think that the non-lecture part is a vital part of a congress or a conference or a camp. Because if that was not the case, you shouldn't have to show up here, because it's all streamed. So if it's just the intel from a talk, you don't have to do this. But we do this, because this is the way we share ideas, and we're very good at that. So hackerspaces, we have those. This is mine, that's Hack42 in Arnhem, and it's awesome. But still, like I said, every now and then you can stay the night there when there's a party, but it's not the same as a hacker camp. And we want to have a hacker camp feel 24/7, all year round. That's the idea. So in order to do that, we're going to send all hackers to jail. Yeah. This jail. The plan is to buy this actual Panopticon prison. It's built in the 1800s something. And until recently, it used to house prisoners. And then after that, some global things happened and some refugees were housed there. But now it's empty, except for some temporary activities like escape rooms and stuff like that. And various stuff like that. It's an actual Panopticon prison. And meaning, of course, that you can be watched all the time. That's why that's the way it's designed. So every prisoner was meant to have the feeling that they could have been watched, which makes you less creative, which for housing prisoners is a good thing, because creative prisoners, of course, keep on figuring new and novel ways out to escape prison. So keeping them uninterested and dumb and, not dumb, but, less creative is a good thing for a prisoner. Of course, in society, that goes the other way around. In society, I think that's a bad thing, to having an idea that you're being monitored all of the time. So the concept is, if you want to fight the Panopticon, you want to own the Panopticon. So that's what we're going to do. That's the building. And we're not just talking about the building, we're talking about the whole facility. So anything within the walls, that's this plot. It's quite big. It's quite enormous. It's huge. It has some nice features, and the main feature, of course, is the dome itself. 408 prison cells. They're quite tiny. And we're going to play with that. It's going to be a play part. Compare it to a hacker camp. What the foundation is going to do, the Beehive 4.2 Tech Campus, is we're going to, like a hacker camp, we're going to rent a field. Well, we're going to buy a plot. And instead of putting tents there, there's already buildings there. But how we're going to fill it? Well, we have some ideas. We have some companies that are willing to chip in and do stuff there. But the actual hacker part of it, I'm not going to plan. Because that's not how we do stuff. The community take care of that. So we're going to have a camp-like structure where we're going to do hacker stuff. And you guys understand that. But the normal people, they go like, you're going to buy your facility and you don't know what you're going to do with that? Yes. I know it's going to be awesome. But that doesn't translate to money speak normally. So that's the problem we're having at the moment. Because it's a huge structure. And there's lots. Let's do a bit more schematic like this. This is office buildings where that's going to be used as office buildings, mainly for companies who will just hire office space. We already contracted a couple of companies to actually do that, and some are actually have signed bills already, so that's good. So that's going to be a major funding part of the whole structure. In the lower left corner, that's going to be the data center. There will be a data center on site that's also going to be used as for heating the rest of the facility. Because, well, you need quite a lot of heat. It's an old building and it's big. So, yeah. This structure, that building is about the same size as Hack 42 is now. So that's going to be Hack 42. So it will not be, we take a hackerspace and we're going to stretch it over this whole plot, because then it will be hard to find each other. Hack 42 will remain Hack 42. This is a Hack 42 project, like all things in the world. But it's not from Hack 42. It's spawned from Hack 42. And so Beehive and Hack 42 are two separate entities that are quite close together, but they're separate. So also legal, is a different legal entity. And that's it. This will house people who come over, and you can stay there for a week, a month, a couple of days, whatever, as long as your project takes. And up here, there will be a bit bigger apartments for if we have speakers that are not in the normal, that are not used to be in a cell size-wise. Then you can house a bit more luxurious, and of course, then prices will go up. But the main part, the dome, which is quite huge and open, I don't know what to do with this, and I'm fine with that. I mean, I know what to do with the cells. I'm going to house hackers and people coming over, but I don't know what to do with the space inside. It's big enough to house the White House, literally, that fits, according to Wikipedia. And you could also put two blue wheels back to back that fits. And you could even walk around it. For scale, elephant. There's a human. Oh, there's a human. There's a human as well, yeah. Divers, yeah. Height-wise, you could put a space shuttle on his tail and then it just doesn't fit, but almost. It's just, yeah, you take the tip off and then it actually works. Well, I've said we a couple of times. We is this bunch of guys. So some of these guys are from the hacker community. Other people know how to play with buildings. Design them, buy them, do stuff like that. So this is the group that's actually doing for it. And, well, we're basically all hackers. But some people hack with buildings and structures and whatever, and we hack the other way. So that's what we're going to do. And, of course, well, we can't do this with just the five of us, so we need some adult supervision. For that, we have a advisory board, which at the moment is Bart Jacobs, information security, computer security, computer information professor from Nijmegen. Ancilla van der Leest, former Pirate Party frontwoman. Jay Blue, the chief information officer from KPN the Netherlands. We have Peter Millenaar. You probably never heard of this guy because he moves in different, how do you call it, in different circles. But he is very proficient in opening doors that were normally closed funding wise. So that's a good one. And our newest member, this is quite new because he doesn't know it yet. We of course talked about it, but yeah, it's the board has decided that you would be an excellent addition to this group. Assel Oosterburg. So yes, and of course there's more to come. Okay, well, how much time do we have for this more to come part? Because there's a timeline, and the timeline is rather strict. We are here. We have 25 days left to place a bid. 25. The bid means it's bid or vision. Because the way this works, it's a public bid, so people can bid, but you only can bid once. So you just state your amount and state your plan. What then will happen that the municipality will look at the plans and they can say yes or no. We do not think this plan has any chance, then it's a no. And yes, we do think it has a chance, that's a yes. So it's not a popularity contest. I mean, if there's three plans, and we're of course not the best ever, and there's a okay plan and there's a shit plan, then the shit plan goes off. But then the two other ones, it's not like we like this the best. No, those two are winners, and then they just look at the bid, the price that they are willing to pay. So yes, we need an awesome plan, but we also need a quite big bundle of cash. And we're working on that, and we think we're working on that quite proficiently, but there's always the need for more. Because of course I have no idea how big the bid is from the other party, for the other parties, and we need to outbid them. So it's not just a play of getting your influence and getting your ideas across. Those are definitely important, but at the moment we need to do that in order to get funding. And well, how to do that? People need to know what you're doing, of course. So we did organize a couple of lectures. Bill Binney gave one, Mitch Oldman. We did information sessions with local police and the people living in the neighborhood. So to teach them how to work your laptop and your IT stuff on the internet. So giving OPSEC sessions to normal people. And also, well, that's of course quite good to show your potential neighbors that it's not that scary to have hackers as neighbors. Because, well, that's what we're gonna do, so we need that. And we also did some sessions for young girls to basically teach them some digital self-defense online. So fend off stalkers and stuff like that. Because that gives you social capital, and of course social capitals don't pay the bill, but with social capital you can, well, yeah, you still can make things happen. And one of our partners, well, one of our core group members also did a project in Utrecht, and there they actually got a social involvement award. The idea is that money will stay within the community and the neighborhood. Those are our goals. So if we need bread for a bakery, and suppose we don't do that on site, that will not be sourced from the other side of the country, but that will be done locally. So, and we're trying to, if we need to employ people, we'll try to also source those locally. So the neighborhood will have people in there that actually work at our facility. So you get a mix match. So that's better for the environment, and it's better for working relations, and I think it's better for the world. And well, and of course, it gives us excellent feedback of the municipality, and that's good. But at the moment, we need cash. And well, we did start a fundraiser that didn't take off the way we thought, but that's actually, that was a good thing, even if it didn't raise, but still running, even if it doesn't raise a bundle of cash. But it does create awareness of what we're doing. And even if you pitch in a couple of euros, it still shows a number. And that number is well, of course, the money amount, but also the amount of people that do that. So if there's a gazillion of people all pitching in 1 euro, that would be awesome. Because that gives you the idea that we're doing stuff that's actually worthwhile. We do have a website, which if our web genius commits at the correct time, then that should be changed. So we have a different website now. And the biggest difference in the website is that we now have a button that says Nu Huur. Is that so?
Yeah.
Ooh. What you do within your cell is totally your own. Sorry? Yes, it is. There are definitely doors. So yes, you can rent a cell, room, office. So what what you can do is rent a cell. And like I said in earlier presentations, that if you can't afford it, then we'll make up another way to do it. So with social capital, that does pay some of the bills. So if we think you're if you're a good addition to the community, then your price will go down, and the other way around. If you just look at us as a cheap office space, prices will go up, and that's the way we're going to do stuff. And well, like I said, a couple of our companies already placed a bid on quite a number of square meters, so that's a good thing. This is a quite short presentation, because I do think there will be a ton of questions. Questions?
Do you have an example question?
Five. Thoughts, ideas, questions? Oh, we're technical.
I can go like this.
Don't throw the system.
You be my microphone man.
This won't be the cube, so don't throw it, please.
As I understood from before, then that will be possibility from the hackers all over the world to come and to stay there.
That's the idea.
And will it be free, or you need to pay something, or you have some idea how?
Well, the facility needs to be paid, of course, at some point. So. If you're a hacker from Brazil that can't afford it, but we think you're doing a great job for the community, then you can't pay for it, so we're not going to make you pay for it, or pay for it whatever you can afford there. I mean, we will give you housing and feed you, so yeah, quite good, isn't it? We found some footage online, because when this was made, we looked at the timestamp. It was still an actual functioning jail, and you're not allowed to make pictures from jail. So the apple, so in the upper left corner, that's definitely not my car. So you find stuff online. So yes, if you can't afford to stay there, and you are a contributing member to our society, there will be a way to actually do that. So you pay by your work instead of paying in coin.
And will you make some organization also for the schools? You know, in Arnhem is also one really good, a nice school, RSC.
Yes.
And they are, I think they will be willing to work with you. Will you make some session
Absolutely.
For the children, or? things like that.
The facility is huge, so we can do a lot of stuff. And yes, having teaming up with universities and schools, and definitely local schools, that's definitely in the pipeline. But like I said, bulk of what we're going to do there, I'm not going to plan. The community will do that. But yes, we're already talking with schools and stuff, because that's going to happen as a definite. But other plans will come up. So even if we haven't thought about that idea, and you come at some point, you come up and you go, let's do this. Like any regular hackerspace, as it functions now, it's like, yeah, if members or people come up with great ideas, those will be incorporated in the plan.
So we can call everyone in the world, not just in Holland, to help us and all help community to buy that, and that everyone from everyone, all the parts of the world, can have benefits from that.
Yes.
Now I will send that message to the world.
And within the next 25 days. <That's>, because there is a timeline that we're, that's the scary part.
Other questions for Jos?
There was a question over there, I think.
Yes.
A suggestion.
Doom, doom, doom,
doom.
No, different mic, yes.
Yeah. Suggestion or question more? Would it be possible to have a lifelong rent of a cell? For example, have another hackerspace go like, as long as our hackerspaces exists, cell 23B is ours.
For the correct price, we can talk. Yes.
Okay. 42 is ours.
No. There will be happening different stuff with cell number 42. yes, there are several ways to take part in this plan. We're looking at some parts that will be sold off, maybe. To get it funded, absolutely, no problem. We can do it. A lifelong lease or whatever, that's definitely doable. Astrid.
Well, Jos, first of all, thanks for the nice part that I can play in your beautiful project. You know, I kicked some ass from the side, so now I will be part of it. That's really cool. I really thank you very much.
Thank you.
Then my second question, you know, I tried to get the mayor over to the Beehive. I will try to get him there again. But what do you need more, because you need money. I know, I understand. Yes. We have the same problem. You put in your plan. I think you have a great vision and a bit. Maybe we can hack the bits from the others.
Now, so we're going to play nice. That's
damn, I'm like that too. So, but what do you need more? What can we do more as a community to help to make this a success?
Well, I need money. I need lots of it. And but more people have that problem, and that's so. I know I'm fishing in the same pond as a lot of people. So what I did as a member of this plan, which is other people as well, I spoke to my boss, and I asked him what the plan was and how he could see himself in that plan. And well, my office is basically next door. And so then it was quite easy to make some shifts. And they are actually gonna hire a couple of office buildings at our site. And they're gonna pay a decent amount for that. And I have that in writing. So I have a guarantee renter. So I can now go to the bank and say, this is my income for the next couple of years. Can I have this bundle of cash to pay for the bid? So stuff like that. So if you are, if you have a job that's within IT or doing pen testing or whatever, ask your employer if they want to house some people there. Like a hacker conference. I mean, a lot of companies went there and just feel the atmosphere of the actual hacker community, which is a valuable thing. We will have a cyber village. And yeah, so it's getting your people street smart, make it interesting. So learning stuff, that can be done there. We already talked to a couple of IT firms that went like, well, this is a very good fishing pond for new blood. So hiring people in or figuring out who to hire or something like that. And yeah, people are willing to pay top dollar for that. There's an English firm that does quite a lot of things, but also does network security monitoring. And one of their leaders was like, well, I have a bunker with people in there, and they're highly skilled people, but they're just in that bunker doing stuff. So he already said to us that once we have this, any one of those guys, most of them are guys, any one of those guys will every year be at least 1 month in our tiny little village. So that's having those things on paper will enable us to get more cash. So it's not cash in hand now, but yeah. So does that answer your question?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Much more what we could do for you. Don't
yes.
ask what I could do.
Well, get the word out.
Yeah, get the word out.
And that's, I've been saying that for quite a long time now, but now get the word out within the next couple of weeks.
Okay. We'll do. We all do.
And get stuff in writing, so it's not just a good idea. Yes?
Yes. Can we paint it cyber yellow?
What you do within your cell, I'm pretty sure you could do stuff.
Not complete.
No. Not
that. There ain't so much yellow paint.
It's not a submarine.
you might hire a world famous artist who will cover it up.
Yeah. It's also a landmark, so let's not. The what?
To make next.
I don't have his number, so that's.
Oh, we can call him on.
Okay, we'll see what happens. But like I said, community will take care of that.
Other questions for us?
Yeah, thank you for your effort, of course, in the Hacker community. And I'm wondering how you're going to communicate our idealistic views in your bid. Because we're very idealistic as a hacker community. How
yes.
are you going to communicate that in a bid?
Well,
I think that's quite hard.
It is quite hard. And actually, it doesn't matter that much if our ideas matter a lot, of course. But having that idea in your bid is not that important, as long as our idea is good enough that the municipality will go like, yeah, I can see this happening. So it doesn't, it needs to not suck. That's basically what it is.
So it's probably more important for us to be good for the community than the community wanting us to be good for them.
At the moment, yes.
At the moment, okay.
Of course, if we have it up and running, then we're going to do what we're good at, and we're going to be this community that contributes to the world, because that's what we do.
Yeah.
But that's hard to put in a bid. In a bid, it basically has to see, yes, this is a viable plan. I can actually pay for this. And the structure I'm putting up will still be there in a couple of years. So if I if I want to turn it into a balabak, and that's all I'm going to do with it, they're going to be, yeah, cool idea, bro, sod off. So that's basically it. So it has to be it has to look grown up-y. That's basically it.
Thank you.
Yes.
Other questions for yours?
And it has to fit within the local rules, of course. That's also one big part that plans will be turned down. So I want to tear down a couple of some of the buildings and put high rise in there. That's not going to happen. That will get your plan booted.
Other questions for yours? From the
I thought
audience?
There would be way more questions.
Come on, guys, you can do better than that.
15.
Okay. Yes, there's a question in the back.
Hoya.
Yes.
There you go.
Did you get any inkling of a European subsidy or other subsidies you might get for the project?
I don't mind if governments throw money at me, but I would mind if they had to throw that money in on a monthly basis or on a yearly basis. Because at some point we'll do something to fuck up the powers that be. And I do not want people to have a kill switch.
So basically lump sum at the beginning and
yes,
no backseas.
Yes, all for that, yes. I do not mind getting monies from people's at this point. That answers your question?
Yes.
Good.
More questions? No? Okay.
Then it's a short one.
Good one.
Okay, thank you very much.
Your talk was very informative. Jos Weijers.